Mayong hapon, kids! Kumusta? Are you ready to let your imagination fly high into the Cebuano sky and your wonder go under unto the depths of Cebuano Sea? In our story this afternoon, you will learn the importance of keeping your promises to your friends, because forgetting about them may lead your friend to be angry at you and to bad consequences. Even the closest friendships can be broken because of an unfulfilled promise. Legends are stories shared across many generations, believed by many to be true, but without proof. Stories and legends can be used to explain a certain phenomenon or a memorable event when we don't really know exactly what happened. The legend of Datu Manggal and Kapitan Silyo will tell you the story of how a small island beside Bugo came to existence. Just like our previous stories, I will be reading this afternoon's story in both English and Cebuano. Are you ready, kids? Datu Manggal and Kapitan Silyo. A long time ago, Lapu-Lapu, the brilliant leader of Mactan and victor over Ferdinand Magellan and Spanish crew, lived with his equally renowned father, Datu Manggal. Kaniadto, nakapuyo si Lapu-Lapu, ang maisog nga pangulo sa Mactan ug mamumuntog ni Ferdinand Magellan ug ang iyang Kastilang kauban uban sa bantugan niyang amahan si Datu Manggal. One of Datu Manggal's close friends was named Kapitan Silyo, who was a Datu of Bugo. Usa sa suod nga mga higala ni Datu Manggal mao si Kapitan Silyo, usa ka Datu sa Bugo. One day, Kapitan Silyo docked his ship on Mactan, where he was welcomed by Datu Manggal and Lapu-Lapu. Usa ka adlaw, ni dunggo ang sakayan ni Kapitan Silyo sa Mactan, ug gisugat siya ni Datu Manggal ug Lapu-Lapu. "Greetings, dearest friend," Datu Manggal explained. "It is good to see you. Pagtimbaya." Suod nga higala, mituaw si Datu Manggal. "Nalipay kayo ko nakakita nimo." "I appreciate the warm welcome, Datu Manggal," Kapitan Silyo replied. "It's good to see you too." "Salamat sa mainit nga pagdapit, Datu Manggal," nitubag si Kapitan Silyo. "Nalipay sab ko nakahimamat nimo." "What brings you to our island?" Lapu-Lapu asked. "Napadpad ka sa among isla," pangutana ni Lapu-Lapu. "I have to visit Haring Tupas in Sugbo. Nakoy tuyo kang haring humabon sa Sugbo." "Oh, really?" Datu Manggal said. "Adi ay," niingon si Datu Manggal, and he turned to look at Lapu-Lapu, ug nilingi siya kang Lapu-Lapu. But Lapu-Lapu said, "Won't you come dine with us before you go? We've prepared a feast." Apan niingon ra si Lapu-Lapu, "Mangaon sa ta, nag-andamig hikay." Not one to turn down food, Kapitan Silyo gracefully accepted. "Of course. Thank you for inviting me. It will give me strength to travel to Sugbo." Wala mubalibad si Kapitan Silyo. "Salamat sa pagdapit kanako. Makahatag kini og kusog alang sa akong biyahe padulong sa Sugbo." As they ate and drank, Datu Manggal and Kapitan Silyo exchanged stories about their kingdoms and the other lands they had conquered. Samtang nangaon o nag-inom silang Datu Manggal o Kapitan Silyo, nagpuli-puli sila og sugilon bahin sa ilang mga gingharian o ang mga laing dapit na ilang ginsakupan in a booming voice so that all the guests attending the feast could hear. Kapitan Silyo said, "Why don't you and Lapu-Lapu come with me back to Bugo so that you can visit my kingdom and behold its beautiful sights?" Unya, sa kusog nga tingog para madunggan siya sa tanang nanambong sa kumbira, ni ana si Kapitan Silyo, "Nganong dili man mo ni Lapu-Lapu mo ban hinoon sa Bugo igbalik aron makaduaw kamo sa akong gingharian? Ug masud-ong ninyo ang matahom nga mga talon-aon dito." Datu Manggal enthusiastically accepted Kapitan Silyo's invitation. Gidawat ni Datu Manggal ang imbitasyon ni Kapitan Silyo. Lapu-Lapu, however, declined, saying that he needed to stay and protect his island in case the Moros attack. Si Lapu-Lapu miingon, nibalibad og niingon nga kinahandan siyang magpabilin aron mapanalipuran niya ang isla in kasong musulong ang mga Moro. "And now, I must go to Cebu for my audience with King Humabon. I will return here after my visit so that you can ride me back to Bugo." Kapitan Silyo promised Datu Manggal. "Ug karon, kinahanglan na akong madto sa Cebu para sa akong pakigpulong kang Haring Humabon. Mubalik ko dinhi pagkahuman aron hapiton tika ug magdungantag adto sa Bugo." Ni saad si Kapitan Silyo ni Datu Manggal. The two men embraced once again before Kapitan Silyo set off on his journey to Cebu. Naggakos ang duha ang kamanag-higala ug usab una ilakaw si Kapitan Silyo ngadto sa Cebu. But Kapitan Silyo never came back. Apan wala na ning balik si Kapitan Silyo. He had forgotten his promise to Datu Manggal and had gone straight home to Bugo. Nakalimot siya sa iyang saad kang Datu Manggal ug di pauli og diretso sa Bugo. When Datu Manggal found out, he was furious. Pagkahibaw ni Datu Manggal, nasuko siya pag-ayo. "My dearest friend has insulted my honor. Kapitan Silyo will pay for this." He rode for Datus were not meant to be forgotten or disrespected in such a way. "Ipakaulawan ko sa akong suod nga higala. Magbayad yun si Kapitan Silyo." Nidahunog ang tingog ni Datu Manggal. Kay ang mga dato, dili angay kalimtan o tamayon. "Fetch my flying horse and ready yourselves for war," he ordered his men. "Kuwaa akong kabayong mulupad o pangandam alang makigubat." Giingnan niya ang iyang mga sagop. "Musunod dayon mo nako samtang galupad ko ibabaw sa mga balud ug absunta ang iyang barko." Datu Manggal's men raced to follow their datu's order. And soon, Datu Manggal had caught up to Kapitan Silyo's ship. Dali nga nituman ang iyang mga sakop sa sugo sa ilang datu, naapsan ni Datu Manggal ang barko ni Kapitan Silyo. "You have betrayed our friendship, Kapitan Silyo. You broke your promise," Datu Manggal thundered. "Nibudhi ka sa atong panaghigalaay, Kapitan Silyo. Imong gikalimtan ang imong saad." Nidagugdog ang tingog ni Datu Manggal. He caught a glimpse of Kapitan Silyo's horrified face before he summoned enough lightning to tear the flying ship into shreds. Nakita niya ang kahadlok sa panagway ni Kapitan Silyo. Una niya gitawag ang kilat ug gilabay kini ngadto sa sakayan nga nabungkag ngadto gagmayng-gagmayng mga bahin. The biggest parts of the ship fell to the water and became a small island. Ang dagkong bahin sa sakayan nangahulog sa dagat ug nahimong usa ka pulo. The trees dotting the island came from the pollen sheaf moss and seals. Ang palo ug layag sa sakayan nahimong kakahuyan nga nanurok sa pulo. The island would then be named Kapitan Silyo Island after the Datu who forgot about his promise. Tawagon kini nga pulo ug Kapitan Silyo gikan sa Datu nga nakalimot sa iyang saad. As of today, you can find this small island beside the town of Bugo. Karon, makita ni nimo nga gamay nga pulo tupad sa Bugo. Kids, did you like the story you just heard? What do you think of the prayers Datu Manggal and the forgetful Kapitan Silyo? Do you think Kapitan Silyo meant to betray his dearest friend on purpose? Was Datu Manggal right to punish Kapitan Silyo without asking for an explanation? Would you end a friendship because of a broken promise? What do you think was the right thing to do? Tell us what you think about the legend, kids. Ask your parents or teacher to send us message at facebook.com/gabiisakabilincebu. Also, there are questions at the end of this video that we'll be posting, so you can talk more about the stories with your parents or teacher. Just remember that every second Friday of the month is storytelling afternoons in Handurawan, Cebuano Tales for Children. Bye, kids!